everyone, Karsty5 here, and welcome to the explanation of my Link to the Past in 3 minutes and 16 seconds video. Now, if you'd like to perform this glitch, make a brand new save file, and name it whatever you want. I'm just going to do hi, just because I did that a few times before. And let's end it. This glitch is a very easy glitch to pull off, and it's not that hard. I actually got it on my first try. But of course, most of the speedrun, or most of my live stream, was optimizing this glitch, as there's a lot of optimizations to be done, just getting to the castle faster and stuff. And so just wait for Zelda to stop talking. And here we go. We're almost there. Okay, he'll be back by morning. So you do not need anything in Link's house. Just get off and let's go. So you need to get to the castle, and it really does not matter what way you get there. I'm just going to go the fastest way, which is up around here. And you need to go over on this side, where if you've probably played Link to the Past before, you know what to do. Grab the, what wrong button? There we go. And you pass through. Now you are in the basement of the castle secret entrance, where you will get the sword and shield from your uncle. Zelda is my what? And that's not really important, because we're going to beat the game anyway. And I don't think it's ever revealed. However, you do see your uncle in the end. Now you can just get through there and walk around. It really does not matter if you get hit, so don't worry. It's not super duper specific on what happens. So now what you need to do up here is avoid the guards where you don't really have to if you don't want to, and jump off this platform. Pause and save and quit. Save and quit. Now just load up your save file again. Now you do not want to get hurt in this section of the run. So just try to make sure that no soldiers bother you. And yeah. So just walk through here again. Go around here. And make sure not to get hit. And now we are back inside the castle. Just walk over here. And yeah, get up here. Walk over here. And go down here, hit this guy so he agitates you, or you agitate him, and you'll pop into this wall. Walk over a few steps so you do not clip back in up here. Slowly walk up, it'll take a while, but the screen will scroll, and eventually you'll get up here. Go one more, and right here, do not press anything, and go right. And if you're lucky, you will not get hit with the black screen, but as long as Link isn't visible, you should be okay to continue going forward. So, now just keep running forward. Keep going past these empty rooms, which were probably used some point for the development process. And now we have some weird rooms. Another empty one. And if you'll just keep waiting, the best part is coming up soon. So now, it's the Ganon fight at the end of the game. And oh, there's Ganon. Oh, there he is again. And boom! There you go. Now you've successfully finished A Link to the Past. Yeah, it's a really easy glitch, and it's a fun glitch to perform to finish the game if you're into speedrunning, or if you want to. The reason why this glitch works is because all of the dungeons are actually connected to each other, so you can get from the first to the last very quickly. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to like and subscribe, and I hope you'll stick around and enjoy my channel. Have a great day. Bye.